Good morning, students. So in next part, that is, we are going to start about the square roots. In previous video, we have discussed about the squares and how we can find the square of that is numbers with the shortcut methods. So now in this part, we are going to discuss about the square roots of numbers. So let's start. So what we are going to learn in this video, that is, first, what is actually a square root, then how we can find out the square roots of the given numbers, and some examples based on it. So let's start with square root. What is square root? Square root of a number is a value that can be multiplied by itself to give the original number. Means, if we are talking about the square root of 16, then the square root of a 16 is that number which, when multiplied by itself, gives you the 16, that is 4. So square root of 16 is 4. Why? Because when 4 is multiplied by itself, we will get 16. Now, what is the symbol used for square root? So for square root of a number, it is indicated by the symbol, this one, which is known as radical sign. This symbol is known as radical sign. So square root of n is written as, that is, radical sign with n, that is said to be a root n. It is also said to be a root n or square root of n. Now, there are some examples. Square of 4. So square of 4 is, square root of 4 is 2. So square root of 4 is 2. That is, if we write mathematically, then it can be written as, that is, under root 4, that is equals to 2. Now, square root of 9, that is 3. So we can write square root of 9, that is equals to 3. Square root of 16 is 4. That is, you can write mathematically, root 16 is equals to 4. Thus, a number n is the square root of number m if. So, what conclusion we will get from here? So, for any natural number n, there is a number m which is a square root of n only when m is equals to n square. So a number n is the square root of m. A number n is the square root of m. So when n is said to be a square root of m, when n is square is equals to m. This is the condition to be a square root. Some picture is given to you to understand. 4 is said to be a square root of 16. Why? Because 4 into 4 is equals to 16. Okay. So how we will get a square root of any number? That is 16 divided by, that is the number which is a square root. Okay. So this is the way how we can understand what is actually a square root. So let's move on next slide. Now, methods of finding a square root. So there are the several methods to finding a square root, but we will discuss one by one. In our book, it is only two methods are given to you. One is your prime factorization method, and second one is your long division method. Now, prime factorization method has a certain limitation, that is, it is applicable only for the perfect square numbers. So, what is perfect square number? That we have already discussed in previous videos. But I want to remind you, perfect squares are those numbers which are the square of natural numbers. These are the square of natural numbers. For example, we have 4 is a perfect square because it is a square of, that is, natural number 2. Now let's discuss of methods. Now here I'm going to provide you a certain more methods of finding a square root. So they are used as of playing with numbers. So the first method is your successive subtraction of odd number. So we can find the square root of any number. So these methods are also having a limitation that they are applicable only for the perfect squares. Okay, so this successive subtraction method of odd number. So what we have to do, suppose that a number is given to you, then what we have to do, we have to just subtract the given number by successive odd numbers, and we have to perform this process continuously till we will get 0. So subtract the odd number by 1, 3, 5 successively from the given number. Stop when the answer is 0. Then count the number of times the odd numbers were subtracted. Here what we have to do now, we have to count the number of times the square, that is subtraction, will be carried out. So let's see with an example. Find the square root of 49. So now what we have to do, subtract 49 by 1, you will get 48. 48 by 3, you will get 45. 45 by 5, you will get 40. Then by 7, 33. 33 minus 9, 24. 24 minus 11, 13. And 13 minus 13, 0. Now in how many steps we will get 0? That is in 7 steps. 7 times we subtract. So the square root of 49 is your 7. So this is also the way, actually it is a time taken method, but we can use a such method also to find out the square root of perfect square numbers. It is only for the fun. So let's enjoy. You can do with some more examples by your own. Now, tens and ones method. Her name is very funny, tens and ones method. All these methods are not given in your book. So just I'm going to give you some extra methods to find out the square root. So don't worry, such questions are not in your exams, but it is only for the fun. So tens and ones method. How we can find out the square root of any number? By using this tens and ones method. But the only, again a limitation is there. It is applicable only for the perfect squares. If the number is perfect square, then you will get the correct answer. Otherwise, you will not. Okay. So this method is used for finding the square root of number up to 4 digits. It is applicable for more than 4 digits also, but we are successfully applying this method with the up to 4 digits. So let's have a certain steps. So what we have to do now, we have to divide the number into two parts. Observe this, first two digits are taken in a group, then that is from start from the ones, then let's have some, I'm going to give writer some. Suppose that you are having a 1, 4. So what you have to do? You have to divide this number in two parts. The first two digits are taken in one part. Now this is your 4. The ones digit carries 4. So in which number the 4 comes? Which number when you multiply it will give you 4. So there are the two numbers, they like when you multiply 2, 2 2s are 4. The square of 2 will give you 4. 8 8 is 64. So 2 and 8. So So what are the possible digits for ones place is 0, that is 2 and 4. So our square root may contains 2 or our square root may contains 4. Okay. Now, so this is your first step. So observe the ones digit of the number and determine the ones digit of the given number using the properties of square. Already we have discussed in property square. Given a number ends with 4, then the possible values of the square root will be, that is 2 and 8. Now strike out the last two digits from the right. Already we have struck out. Now if none of the digits remains, the ones digit obtained above is the square root. Suppose that there is no third digit, then it may be that whatever will be the answer, that ones digit is only the answer. Suppose that you are having 81. What are the possible values for the one? That is one only. Okay, and 9. But there is no third digit. So one is not a square root of 81. So next possibility will be, that is 9. So 9 is your answer. So this is the way how we can find out. So if there is no digit remains after removing our two digits, then the unit digit will be only the answer. If there are certain digits, like here is 1, then we have to move on third step. So next, consider the remaining digit on the left. Determine the largest one digit number whose square is less than or equal to this leftover number. So we have to find out a number, largest number, which when multiplied, it may be equals to 1 or it may be less than 1. So 1 only, that is 1 only. So your answer will be, that is the possible values of square root will be your, that is 1 is your 12 and another one will be, that is it may be 18. Okay, so now we can check here, okay, our possible square root will be 12 and 18. So that is 12 will be your. So this is the way how we can find. So let's see with an example so you can understand well. Find out the square root of 6561. Now ones digit of 6561 is 1. So the possible values of one digit at the square root is either 1 or 9. That is 1 or 9. Okay. So our answer maybe ends with 1 or ends with 9. Now when you remove the two digits, what is left? 65. What is left? 65. Now the square of, that is 8, that is 64, is the largest square, that is 1 less than the number 65. If we take a next, that is 981, which is greater than 65. So what number we have to choose? A number whose square will be either less than or equals to the remaining number. Okay, so we have to find out the greatest number whose square will be either less than this 65 or equals to 65. So that is possibility will be your 8. That number is your 8. Therefore, this means that now the possible square roots will be your either 81 or it is 89. Now we are having only two numbers, just go through it and check it. So when you find do the multiplication, you'll find that the square of 81 is your 6561 while 89 is your 7921. Okay, so our required answer will be 81. So this way we can if the number is a perfect square, then very easily you can reach the square root. So this is a shortcut way how we can find out the square root. So this is applicable for the 6 digits also, 5 digit also, but we have discussed only for the 4 digits number. So you can do it. Next is your square root of perfect square by prime factorization. This is the method that is given in your book. So how we can find out the square root with the help of prime factorization. So again, we have to follow the certain rules. Rule number one, resolve the given number into prime factor. So what we have to do in first step, we have to find out the prime factors of that is given numbers. In second step, make a pair of all the factors. Okay, then take the product of prime factors choosing one from each pair. Now see how many pairs are formed. Now from the each pair you have to take one number and you have to find the product of all these prime factors. Okay, and that will gives you the square root of the given number. So let's see. Suppose that we have to find out the square root of 2704. So now what we have to do? First we have to find out the prime factorization of 2704 by division method. Okay, so that will be your 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 13 into 13. Now make a pair of them. When you make a pair, then the pair of 2s are formed, that is there are the two pairs of 2 and one pair of 13. Now from each pair you have to take one number. So 1, 2, from here again 1, 2, and here we have to take 13. Then 2 2s are 4 and 13 4s are 52. So this is your square root of 52. That is square root is your 52. Now one more example, that is 14400. Again you have to do the prime factorization. Prime factorization is your 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5 into 5. Make a pair. When you are making a pair, then you have to keep the number in square root only. Then make a pair. Then for each pair, you have to write 1, 2. Then just multiply it, you will get the answer. So this is the easiest way to find out the square root of any number. But this is again only applicable for the perfect squares. Now, let's see some word problems based on it. In an auditorium, the number of rows is equals to the number of chairs in each row. If the capacity of the auditorium is 2025, find the number of chairs in each row. So in auditorium, what is the condition given to you? The number of rows, that is the number of rows is equals to the number of chair. So if we take the number of chairs in each row be x, if we take the number of rows, that is number of chairs in a row is x, then the number of rows is also equals to x. And then how many chairs will be there? The number of chairs, that is the number of chairs in that auditorium, that is equals to number of rows into number of chairs in each row, that is x into x, that is equals to x square. Now this x square is equals to that is 2025, because it is also given to you that the number of capacity. So number of capacity, only that people only sit now, that the number of chairs are there. So it means x square is equals to 2025. So now we have to find out the square root of 2025 to get the value of x. So do the prime factorization, write the factors, make a pair, then write 1 1 from each pair, multiplied you will get 45. So there are 45 chairs in each row. How many chairs are there? 45 chairs are there in each row. Easy. Now we are having a few different questions are also there. Find the smallest number by which 396 must be multiplied so that the product becomes a perfect square. Okay. As we already discussed, this prime factorization method is applicable only for finding the square root of perfect square number. Suppose that if a non-perfect square number is given to you, then what will happen? As we know, if it is a non-perfect square number, Suppose that 396 is not a perfect square number. So 396 is not a perfect square number. So how we can see, how we can say that it is not a perfect square? Because when we factorize it, we will see that we have a pair of 2, we have a pair of 3, but the 11 is left alone. There is no pair for 11. So now how we can make this number perfect square? We are having a two ways. Either just remove 11 from here, or just give one more 11, multiply 11 to 396, so that it becomes a perfect square. So we are having a two options. One, to multiply a number, small number, smallest number, or we have to divide one smallest number. So by which number we have to multiply or divide? We are having a two option. So that smallest number will be the number which is alone. The number which is alone. So here 11 is alone. So we need to either remove this 11 from here, so it becomes a perfect square. The remaining part will having a pair, so it becomes a perfect square. And another one, that is to multiply 11. So since it is asked us to find the smallest number which must be multiplied, so if we multiply 11 here, so all the numbers get paired. But when we will get 11 here, and 11 is multiplied 396, so one more 11 is required here. So the required number is your 11, which is multiplied by 396 to make it a perfect square. Similarly, if a question is which number is divided, then again you have to write 11 is the required number, which when by which if 396 is divided, the quotient will be a perfect square. Okay. So let's discuss one more example. Find the least square number divisible by each 8, 9 and 10. Now what the question says? We have to find out a least square number. It means it is a perfect square. So we have to find out a perfect square, a smallest perfect square number, which must be divisible by 8, 9 and 10. So when we are talking about the least number, then we have to find out the LCM. So take the LCM of 8, 9 and 10, because the LCM of 8, 9 and 10 is the only number which is divisible by all these three numbers, 8, 9 and 10. So the least number divisible by each 8, 9 and 10 is the LCM. So when we find the LCM, your answer will be, that is 360. So LCM of 8, 9, 10 is 360. But we know that 360 is not a perfect square. It is not a perfect square. Yet 360 is divisible by 8, 9 and 10, but it is not a perfect square. So when we do the prime factorization of 360, we will get 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 5. So there is a one pair of 2, one pair of 3, but 1, 2 and 1, 5 are left. Now we have to find out a perfect square which is divisible by this number. Now any number, if you multiply any non-zero number, now in this number 360, that number is always divisible by 8, 9 and 10, because it is a multiple of 360, and all the multiples of 360 is divisible by 8, 9 and 10. So now we have to make 360 a perfect square. So if you want to make it perfect square, then we are having two options: either remove 2 and 5, or give one more 2 and one more 5, so that it becomes a perfect square. So now it needed a one more 2 and one more 5. It means 2 5s are 10. So when you multiply 10 in 360, then it becomes a perfect square. So 360 into 10 is the required number, that is 3600. So 3600 is the least square number. It is the least square number, perfect square number, which is divisible by 8, 9 and 10. Okay. So now we are going to end our session here. In next session, we will learn about the long division method, which is also known as Brahmastra of finding a square root. So let's discuss in the next video. Till you have to do your exercise 3C or query, you can come and ask in your comment box. Be safe, stay at home. Thank you very much.